Today's video is about balance at the finish, the Ted Rhodes finish, swinging in balance and getting those cleats to be able to be seen. Doc Blade, Forensic Golf. So let's put the final piece to the puzzle. We've talked about the pressure. We talked about the rear arm awareness, the target side awareness. We talked about swinging along the body line, correct? We talked about feeling that by the time you get to P3, you already feel your pressure on your target side. We talked about speed out in front and away from you. Now the final piece of the puzzle is what I call the Ted Rhodes finish. A nice, beautiful finish where if I stand behind you, I can count your cleats. Anecdotally, that does so many great things. If you get to that finish, I know where you are. Even Gary Player, who had to walk through. The reason he did the walk through was to make sure he got everything over to the target side. That's a drill that I do for my clients. The Gary Player drill. I have them hit balls, and when they hit the ball, they walk through. You'd be surprised at how many people have so much difficulty with that drill because they so used to playing golf with the weight staying on the rear. So I want you to get to what I call that beautiful Ted Rhodes finish. That's the final piece of the puzzle. Work on one piece of the puzzle until you feel you have it, you know, inside of you, and then go to another piece. Over the 16 week period, you're gonna really take some strokes off your golf game. The Ted Rhodes finish. Beautiful. Work on this. It's going to change the game. Spend some time on it, and I guarantee you, the journey requires work, but the end result is going to be lower scores and more fun. So the last four or five videos, last month and a half, we went over everything that I call the essentials, the awarenesses, elbows, rear arm awareness, target side awareness, feeling along with the target side, with the rear side, elbow pocket up, then rotate it around, right? We talked about the pressure, more pressure on the target side, feel like you're playing golf going downhill. We swing in the club along our body line. Right? By the time we get to P3, we already feel the pressure is back to the target side, so we try to keep it over there. Even though we know the pressure goes to the rear and comes back, we try to get it on the target side as long as possible and get it over there fast. That way we get a linear, lateral swing trace, right? We talked about that. We talked about getting the speed out in front, up high and away from you. And then the final piece of the puzzle is the Ted Rhodes finish. I want you to feel that you're posing and profiling at the golf ball, okay? The person behind you should be able to count your cleats. We know so many things can happen that way, all right? So you put all that together, you work on one piece of the puzzle at a time, and I'm trying to tell you, it's going to work and make a difference. I have clients that I just get them hit like five balls with the Ted Rhodes finish, right? And then I hit them hit five balls without thinking about it. And eventually they start getting to that pro finish and they start hitting some really good shots because anecdotally, you're starting to release the ball. And remember, we always throwing the bejesus out of it, correct? We always throwing the bejesus out of it. Google Ted Rhodes and Dr. Charlie Sifford. Check out their 2D pictures of their gorgeous finishes and you'll understand why I call this the Ted Rhodes drill. Thank you.
Thank you.